And so Paul, in his first encounter with the other apostles at Jerusalem, look at Galatians chapter 2. When Paul went to Jerusalem to meet with the other apostles, Galatians chapter 2, look at verse 6. Paul said, but from those who seemed to be something, I'm still talking about 49 AD, says, but from those who seemed to be something, whatever they were, it makes no difference to me. Paul was referring to the other apostles. Paul was referring to those who were in the ministry before him. Those you will consider to be his senior, his leader. In fact, when you go to verse 11, when you go to verse 11 of Galatians chapter 2, Paul said in verse 11, now when Peter had come to Antioch, I withstood him to his face because he was to be blamed. So Paul said, I don't care what who they may be. Those of them who may think that they are something. Oh, I am also someone. I am the man. I am also an apostle. And so we see from the timeline that Paul was high up there. He thought also he was the man. He thought he was an apostle of the same caliber and of the same rights and privileges as the others. And so he said in verse 6 of Galatians, he says, for from those who seemed to be something, whatever they were, it makes no difference to me. He says, God shows personal favoritism to no man. For those who seemed to be something added nothing to me. So even though they may think that they are something, there is nothing that I'm getting from them. The Queen of England is reigning in England. The Queen, the King of Oyo is reigning in Oyo town. And no king is subject to another one. You know, that's the language of arrogance. That's the language of what? Of pride. And so Paul thought he was up there. But by AD 57, by 57 AD, Paul had come down a notch. And that was when he wrote this 1 Corinthians chapter 15, the epistle, the letter to the church at Corinth. And he said there, verse 9, he said, for I am the least of the apostles. Originally he said, I am an apostle. And after walking with the Lord for a while, he came to realize that sometimes your next level might not be climbing up. Your next level might be coming down a little notch. Your next level might be breaking certain hardness in you. Your next level might be removing the chips that you have on your shoulders. And so by AD 57, he referred to himself as the least of the apostles. And then he took a notch further down. By 64 AD, Ephesians chapter 3 verse 8. By 64 AD, Paul referred to himself as less than the least of the saints. Ephesians 3:8 says, to me, who am less than the least of the saints, his grace was given that I should preach among the Gentiles the unsearchable riches of Christ. Now he came down a little more notches. From I'm an apostle. He said, oh, I'm the least of the apostles. And then he said, even among the saints, I consider myself to be the least. And by AD 66, Paul referred to himself as the chief sinner, as his death was imminent. 1 Timothy chapter 1. You know, the letter to Timothy he wrote while in prison, while he was waiting to be killed. 1 Timothy chapter 1 verse 15. 1 Timothy 1:15 says, this is a faithful saying and worthy of all acceptance, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners, of whom I am chief. So Paul said, he started by saying, I'm an apostle. He He said, oh, now, after working with the Lord for a while, he came to realize that the way up is down. He said, okay, I'm the least of the apostles. Because he wanted more grace, he humbled himself the more. He said, among the saints, I'm the least. And he said, oh, I now realize who I really am. I know who I am. I am nobody but a sinner saved by grace. And so we see Paul here coming to the realization of who he was, a sinner saved by grace. Brethren, anytime you see a turtle on the fence post, you need to know that the turtle did not get himself there. Somebody took the turtle there. And we are like that turtle. Where you are today, you need to realize that you didn't bring yourself to where you are today. God, using people, brought you to where you are today. And so you must never forget where you are coming from. You must never, you know, sometimes after enjoying some level of success, it is possible you forget that you came from dust. Very easily you forget. Then you think you are all that. Very easily you forget that you are a sinner saved by grace, maintained by grace. And you begin to see yourself as being invincible. You begin to see yourself as being all that. But God brought Paul from his high chair, and he brought him to the realization that he is nobody but a sinner saved by grace. And so you must never forget the one